Hello, everybody. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Paige, this is Seeking Alexandria, and you guys, I'm actually really excited for today's video. I mean, I'm excited for all videos like this, but let's be honest, I love foundation reviews, and in my previous, it was probably like 1 or 2 days ago, you guys will have watched a full face of first impressions using like all higher-end-ish makeup, like definitely more like the Ulta Sephora-y type price point of makeup, and in that video, I talk about how I have all these foundations I need to review, and one of them is the Makeup Forever Ultra HD foundation stick. And as I was reviewing in that video the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Skin, I was sitting here thinking the whole time, like in the last couple of days, all I've thought about is how I want to try this. And I'm just like, I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's because it's so hyped. I've heard so many people talk about it, but it's been on the market for a couple of years, so it's not something like many people talk about currently. And I just like, I want to know for myself. So in today's video, we're just going to hang back. I know that you guys love foundation reviews and I love foundation reviews, so we're going to do this and I love it. So we're going to jump into it. Now, normally in a foundation review, just going to get this out of the way, I'd split my face right down the middle and I prime and prep one on one side, one on the other for a primer, or even just a different technique depending on what I'm testing. And that was going to be the case today. However, somebody was in their Tatcha Silk Canvas right here, which is what I was going to use on just this half. But when I dug in, I wasn't paying attention because I was watching this thing called Chicago Fire. Big mistake. I mean, great show, but like, don't watch that when you're trying. I gouged out so much makeup and I was doing this. Before I know it, I'm like massaging it into my skin and I was like, well, you just put that all over your face, didn't you? So as a primer, there is not a two-sided difference today. I just wanted to let you guys know if that is what you're used to. I apologize, but we are going to see how it works with this today. And actually, I think that it'll work out just fine because this is a really nice like pore filling primer. And this is an HD, more natural to matte finish, I think, from what I've heard. So I think it'll work out pretty good. But this is what is all over pressed into my skin. And then I kind of love setting, I kind of love to do this. I love pressing and like setting my primer with the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Water. I just think this is such a good primer, a good spray for your skin. It has this way of like mixing with whatever your primer is and really just like melting everything in. I don't know. I love it. It helps make my skin feel like really refreshed and happy before I go in with any more products. So those are both already on my face, ready to rock. And I do want to dive in real quick to this little description. And I had to pull this up on the Sephora website. I went to the Makeup Forever website and there was like no description. It was a bunch of reviews, but no description. So I was like, that's annoying. And you guys know I prefer to get my description for my product from where I bought it, but I could not find it. So on the Sephora website, this has 4 out of 5 stars. On the Makeup Forever website, this has 4.9 out of 5 stars. So, it says on Sephora that this is a foundation stick with long-lasting, invisible coverage for touch-ups and contouring, plus all the benefits of award-winning Ultra HD liquid foundation. Coverage is full, finish is natural, it is a stick formulation, I couldn't think of the word, and skin type is for normal, dry, combination, and oily. And then under what else you need to know, it says this creamy blendable formula glides on like a second skin from medium to full coverage with a natural finish. The complexion appears more even toned, hydrated, and flawless. Ultra HD is particularly best suited for those with dry skin. Well, now you tell me. I saw, okay, well, we're going to try anyways. It said oily. To be fair, it said oily. So we're going to jump into this. Now, I have this in the shade Y225, and I think it'll be a pretty close match. I have their pump version of their Ultra HD foundation. I actually wore that a ton, like a year or so ago, and I really liked it. So hopefully this isn't bad. Really, why would they put that it's best for dry skin, and why would you put that down there? See, this is what happens when you don't read that full description, honey. Okay, so let's go ahead and I want to just... See, I don't think... It's going to be a little bit yellow, but I think it'll be okay. Let's go ahead and get you guys scooched in. Why are you so far away? What is happening? Oh, hello there. Now that you guys are all good and happy and zoomed, let's go ahead and talk about how I'm going to be applying this. So on this side of the face, I will be going in with my Real Techniques, a little beauty sponge here. And then on the other side, I will be going in with a brush, which we'll get to that here in just a second. Now, when it comes to stick foundations on my skin, which I have very, very textured and oily skin, but more so in this for this moment, textured. And I've noticed that with stick foundations, if I do not really work and press them into the skin, they will not work on my skin very well. So for the most part, I'm going to be testing it out with this sponge, but I will try it with a brush if I feel like I need to try and build coverage or something like that. But with a stick foundation, if you notice that you're having a hard time building, oh, that actually isn't a bad match at all. If you notice you're having like a hard time either like building coverage or anything like that, like I understand the natural instinct is to go in with a brush, but I just honestly have found that I've used like the Hourglass, L'Oreal, I've tried Maybelline, like I've tried so many foundation sticks, and every time I try to do it with a brush, it's no good. So I'm gonna start kind of beating this into my face a little bit, and my goal with this foundation is to see how full coverage is full coverage and how much it takes, because I have heard that this is a great foundation for not even just like, oh, you guys are a little too close. Are you a little? I feel like you are. That's a little bit better. Okay. I feel like, by the way, this is just a really, really chill, like chill video. So I hope you don't mind. It's not nearly as structured because I was sitting here and I had a totally different video plan for today. And I was like, I need to try this foundation. Like I physically can't wait anymore. So hope you don't mind. And that actually does look really nice. Obviously, I'm going to go in and add a little bit more because my coverage through here isn't crazy. But I heard that this foundation is super great as far as like if you have issues with texture, if you have issues with overall like your skin just looking really like really chunky, or again getting like that more what is that, kind of like that pilled effect. A lot of people said that this foundation is great if you have that type of an issue with your skin, which I really do. So I'm just excited to see if I can have this look like really like second skin on my face. That's what I'm in this for. I want this to look very nice and second skin like, which so far I love the way that this is sitting on my face. Like that's a bad sentence, but seriously, that looks really pretty, and it is a really nice, like I'm getting a nice sheen on it, so I can see where they're saying dry skin for sure, because it's very nice, natural, almost natural to satin, I would say, as far as finish goes, and it's not like clinging or getting weird at all, but it's also not giving me super duper full coverage right in here. So I will go ahead and I'm going to switch to this side and start in with a brush, which means you girl got to figure out what brush you're going to use. So for the brush side, I want to try the Sigma Flat Kabuki. This is their F80. The Sigma Kabuki is a great foundation brush. I really, really like it. So I have about the same amount of foundation on this side, and we're just going to grab that Sigma brush, and we're going to work to bust this bad boy on here. Ooh, all right, that's not bad. Let's go in for a little more coverage here. I think I read online a lot of people use these Makeup Forever sticks. They use them as, I think, contour sticks and stuff like that. They're just super popular. And this does come in, it said on their website, 21 shades. And I looked at the shade range on some of their arm swatches. They don't look bad. I definitely don't think they have enough colors in this line. It seems like they're very, very light on the deeper skin tones, but I am going based off of online swatches, which I know sometimes can be like a little bit shoddy. So if you guys have any experience with their color range, please leave it down below. Okay, so that actually built up pretty good. I don't love as much the way that it's sitting on this side. I think it looks good, but I would still choose to press that side in with a beauty blender. So I'm going to grab, I want to see if I can build up product on this side and like try to build up a little bit of coverage right there. So I just went ahead and I lightly dabbed it on, and now I'm just going to kind of poopsie whoopsie it around and see. Okay, so I am getting a little bit of extra coverage, but when I apply with a brush, I just feel like I can tell that it's not being really pressed into the skin. And I'm just going to take this and kind of press over one more time. I have to say, though, this is really nice. I don't think that it's like, if you have really dark discoloration or like acne like I have right here, I don't think this is like a straight full coverage for you. But if you have a slightly lighter acne or what are those, like acne scarring, anything like that that's in the lighter red to like pink area, I think this would cover that really nicely because I'm getting some decent coverage and like evening out of my skin tone through there. I like it though. I like the way it's sitting really well. Like this, that's probably my favorite. Now I'm just giving myself this one last layer, and I'm going in one more time with the sponge. Because again, I want to really see how well I can build this up. And it actually, like, okay, it's building okay, but what gets me about this is that it's building in very thin layers, I guess you could say. Then I think that that's why the coverage isn't like holy wow, because this has a way of just like thinning out so nicely, which again, I can feel that there is definitely some oil in this, which I'm thinking is why it's so good for dry skin. But this feels really nice on the skin. See, that's the worst part about being an oily skinned person, is that the oil, that when it goes on, like, it feels really nice, because even when you have oily skin, you still like that hydrated, supple, glowy feeling. The problem is that it ain't gonna last for shit on my skin, but it feels really nice. So that's good. I'm just like, you know, I don't know how long it's gonna last, but that's why we're here. So let me go ahead and we're just gonna work this down onto the neck. It's not quite my shade, but it's pretty damn close. And I'm not sure if it's gonna pick up, but you can definitely see like that dewy kind of look to the skin. But it's not dewy in the same sense that the, what was that one that I just reviewed? The Laura Geller Filter First Foundation. I can link that up here for you guys. But I put out that video and that is a dewy foundation. Like, holy crap, very dewy. The Makeup Revolution Stick Foundation, which is this guy right here. I also did a swatch and review of like the lightest four shades of this collection. I can link this video up here as well. This is a very, very dewy stick foundation, and it's not dewy in the same sense that this one is, or even in the Laura Geller sense. You can tell that this one is, has a dewy look to it, but it's because of its like oil based kind of feel that it's giving off, but it still is like a really nice feeling on my skin. Okay. Anyways, I'm going to grab my Tarte Shape Tape here. This is in the shade Fair, and I am going to conceal up my face, and I'm not going for anything like super crazy today, so I'm not gonna do too much in the makeup department. Yeah, I have to be honest, you guys, if I had to like pick my favorite way to apply that, I think that the brush, like, I can understand why if you didn't have like a lot of texture and if you didn't have big pores, I can see why people would choose to do it with a brush, because it's really quick and it goes on nicely, but it doesn't settle in to your skin nearly as nicely as it does with one of these, beauty blender, there we go, or a sponge. Oh, but it feels so good. Now, the reason that I picked the Tarte Shape Tape for this little mission, if you will, is because a lot of people report that the Tarte Shape Tape is very, very dry on their skin, so I wanted to see how that would pull with a more oily type of product like this Makeup Forever HD Stick, and so far, it's actually blending in really nicely. I like the two of them together. There are sometimes I've noticed that, like, if you try a more mattified concealer, or even a concealer that mattifies, or vice versa, a dewy concealer with a mattifying foundation, they just look so crazy. Like, it'll literally look like desert, like ocean, and you can see such a difference on your face, like, and it's, ugh, it never looks good. I don't know. So I wanted to see if these would mix together and how they went together, and so far I love it. Wow. Okay. You know what would also be a beautiful concealer with this? That frickin' Too Faced Born This Way concealer that I love, that I put in a box that I keep forgetting to grab. Where is that? Uh-oh. Dang, guys, that looks so nice. It looks very, very natural. But see, my biggest thing is that the finish looks natural, but I can still see like very light amounts of like the impurity in my skin coming through. And for that reason, I'm like, is this really full coverage? Like, I don't know that I would call this full coverage to be able, okay, because here's the thing. There's two different versions of full coverage. You can say, oh, this is immediately full coverage in the same sense that the, like, Catrice HD Liquid Full Coverage. This is a foundation, the foundation drops. I love these. And these are full coverage on the skin almost instantly. You don't really have to build them up. It's not something where you have to put on a lot. Same with the Dior Forever Undercover and that type of a product. That's just very full coverage very quickly, which is great if that's what you're going for, obviously. But these are a different type of full coverage. And I think with this foundation stick, what they mean is this is buildable to full coverage. This is something that if you put on a little bit, you're going to get a much more natural look. If you put on more, you can get it to a nice full coverage. My biggest concern with this foundation, though, is that if you build it to full coverage, I think that you could lose that really beautiful look and shift and the nice lightweight feel I'm getting. And that to me would be like the biggest shame of all, because if you give that up, I just, it would be like just another stick foundation. And right now it looks so beautiful. All right, move you guys out here just a little bit, and I'm gonna grab my Maybelline Fit Me powder here. This is an 05 Fair, and I want to grab this and apply this mainly under the eyes, but I will also be using a very light amount of it to set the rest of my face. Obviously I am, like I said, oily skinned, so I do have to set my entire face, but I don't want to cake this up. So we're just gonna be very mindful. You always repat out that those under eye bags, because girl, they are real. And we are just applying this on all the concealer areas of my face while still using the damp beauty sponge, which is still nice and damp. A damp beauty sponge will just help you guys really meld it and press it into the skin. It can make a world of difference. Lightly, lighty setting, lightly, lighty setting, setting my face, setting it very lightly. Okay, you guys, I went ahead, I got everything all set, and I'm liking the way that this feels right now. I am gonna hurry up, run off real quick, finish the rest of my face, and I'll be right back. But before I go, I just wanna mention, I really like the way that this settled onto my face, and mainly the way that it sat in and on and like around my textures and my big old pores up here. I really like that. Like, I'm impressed. I'm kind of hoping that it can go one of two ways. When something on my skin, especially that is more oil or more luminous or anything like that, that has that really nice slip feel that settles in very nicely, it tends to break up. So I'm just like, I'm nervous, but I'm excited for what's happening next. So I'm gonna run off real quick and I will be right back. All right, you guys, I went ahead, I finished up the rest of my face, just super light makeup today. And I have to be honest, I'm really loving the way that this is looking. As I started putting on the rest of my products, I was trying out some new stuff. I have one of the Karity blush bombs on my face right now. So there's like a little bit of different product that I think might be kind of emphasizing some texture. The highlight from that blush bomb, I think, is emphasizing a little bit. But for the most part, everything really went on and looks very nice. I think it's giving a really nice kind of luminous quality. It's mixing really well with like my primer and my concealer. Like, I can tell that everything is starting to jive. My biggest concern is going to be breakage. I think up through here, that texture staying really emphasized, that could be an issue. And my second issue that I foresee is going to be around the nose area, because this is so oily, I'm afraid it's just gonna like slough right off. But other than that, I really think that like this is gonna be a good, interesting wear test, because it's oily, I'm oily, like it's gonna be battle of the oil, battle of like the slickiness. So I'm excited. I don't know, I like this. Now, if you are curious, I do have, other than that Karity blush bomb, I also have on my lips right now, this is one of the L'Oreal Colorish Shine lipsticks. I always say that wrong. This is in the shade 904 Varnished Rosewood, and I love this color. These are like a lipstick gloss melded together, these little silver things. I love these. These are so nice. And then what else is on me? Just my Princess Cut from my Park Ave Princess palette. And then, what color is that? Crown. I worked the color Crown from that same palette into my crease, and that is it. All of that aside, I'm going to get running off of camera, and I will be back at the end of the day. We're going to check in. We're going to see what's going on. We're going to get up close and uncomfortable. There we go. And I will check in with you guys and see how everything wears at the end of the day. Whew, God, what a day, but not so bad, right? I mean, that highlight is a blinding situation. But okay, hello, hi, how you doing? Okay, let's go do life, let's go do life. Ooh, look at the bob. Ooh, that's a good wiggle. Ooh, that's a good hair wiggle. I live for a good hair wiggle, yes. All right, you guys, I am back. It has been just over 8 hours on my face, and I definitely have some thoughts for my check-in for this foundation. So the first thing I wanna say is I was actually really impressed with how well this photographed. I took photos, obviously, in here for my thumbnail. I took some out in natural light, and I also shot a video, which you will have seen already earlier in the week, of my September favorites. Oh, you saw it on Monday. I can link that up here. And in that video, and in this video as well, you can really see just like my skin looks very even and balanced. This is a really beautiful on camera. It really does give you like that HD effect, which is nice because it's holding up to its name. I love that aspect of this. I also really loved the way that all of my products, for the most part, sat on top of it. I felt like everything was really even throughout the day. I didn't have any issues there. When I first put on the highlight, I told you guys it was a little bit more textured, but other than that, no issues. Everything really did stay put. Now, my biggest con with this is that this texture up through this area never did calm down. down. So I think what I want to do for this foundation is I want to give it another shot, but with other products. So I'm actually just going to cut this out. I'm going to bring you guys up close and give you, again, a little bit more of an up close situation here, but then I'm going to cut off and I'm going to go to the next day. And I want to try this with a different primer, and I want to try this with face products that I normally know and use, because I did go in with a highlight that I'm not 100% always on with. So I'm hoping that maybe if I go in with a highlight that I know is one I would normally use and that kind of thing. I just want to give it a fair shot because this is so close to actually being very, very nice. Now let's go ahead and bring you guys in real quick because I want you to take a look at the problem areas that I'm seeing. Overall, I did stay nice and matte, I would say, through my T-zone, the forehead, the chin, all of that. You'll see the breakage on my nose was like my main issue, along with the texture and my smile lines on the side of my face. But other than that, everything really did stay nice. It stayed in place. I don't have very many complaints about it at all. So let's go ahead, jump over to the next day, and let's see if we can maybe make this just a little bit better than it is right now. But after 8 hours with this Tatcha primer, I'm not impressed. I just really want to see if I can like make it stick to my nose a little bit better. So let's get to the next day. Okay, you guys, so it is the next day. I'm sure you're wondering about all of this. If you haven't seen it yet, I can link it up here. It is the new Urban Decay Cherry Palette, and I did talk about that. I used that. We did a whole thing. So if you are curious, you can go check that out. But for today, I used a split primer situation. So I went in on this side with my Smashbox Photo Finish Primerizer right here. I did it just on this. It's like a primer moisturizer in one. And then on this half of the face, I went in with my Maybelline Baby Skin Primer right here. And yeah, Instant Pore Eraser. I've used this a ton, and I noticed that I actually had an issue with this one because it is more of like a silicone based. I wasn't sure how this foundation would like stack up against it. And I noticed right in this area, I actually had an issue with my foundation when I applied my bronzer, just completely coming off. Like I had to go in with my MAC Studio Fix powder foundation and do like a little patch in that area, which is crazy. I've never had that happen before. And I think it's just because this is like so oily and so like slicky and that everything like on top of it just kind of comes right off. But then at the same time, after I set it, everything started to calm down and I actually look kind of dry, like in matte in this area. I don't know. It's weird. And I also applied it a little bit differently today too. I went in with my Juno & Co. sponge to see if I could change the coverage and just kind of change the outcome. And what I noticed is that so far I'm looking a little bit smoother today. I think the sponge made a big, big difference. But I am still looking super textured up through here. So I am going to definitely go do my day. I'll step back on at the end. And at this point we will have tried three primers, a silicone base, more of like a moisturizer primer based, and then of course that Tatcha Silk Canvas to really get in there. So I'm curious to see how this wears. I will definitely stop back on at the end of the day. We're gonna see how it goes. But yeah, I just wanted to stop in, show you guys where we're at, and I will see you at the end of the day. Okay, you guys, it is finally the end of a very long day. I've been wearing this foundation for about 9 hours now, and I definitely have some final thoughts that I really feel like are going to sum up this whole situation with this HD stick foundation. So let's kind of get into yesterday and the issues that I had yesterday. I know for you guys it's been all of about 12 seconds since you saw that last clip. For me it has been much longer. So here's the thing. Yesterday when I wore it and I had the Tatcha Silk Canvas all over, I really felt like my face never got into that sweet zone where it was just like nice, relatively smooth, and just like looking good overall. And so today when I did my split primer, I feel like we were really able to accomplish that goal. And I'm glad that I tried this with different primers on this one, because I feel like it really drove home who will get the most use out of this foundation. So on this side of my face, I had an issue where this morning, like I told you, it kind of sloughed off in here. It sloughed off on the side of my nose a little bit, and you guys will see all of this in the close-up, of course. But I had a lot of issues with this side kind of sliding around, which had that Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser from Maybelline, which is that more silicone slip feel. Then on this side where I had that Smashbox Primerizer, this one right here, which is the moisturizer and primer in one. This is something that a lot of like combo to dry to normal skin people really love this. I love it because it makes my skin feel very like nice and exuberated and fresh, and it just soaks into the skin, and I love how smooth it feels when it's freshly applied and all of that. So I love this even though I have oily skin, but I don't love it like, you know, to help with my oil. I just like the way it feels, and I feel like all of my foundations sit really nicely on top of it. Well, this side, worked beautifully. I felt like this side, there was no sloughing. Nothing kind of came off when it shouldn't have. I didn't have issues like that, but it did work beautifully to smooth. Now, both sides this morning did end up venturing into what I call my sweet space. Right around like 2 to 3 hours, I felt like things were nice and smooth. All that texture really did diminish. It didn't go away completely in this area, but it was a lot less, which was awesome. So I think for me, I can definitely tell that this foundation, because it has so much like oil slick feel to it, it does perform, or I think it would perform better for like a dry skin right on that side of the spectrum. I think if you're oily, you might not hate it, but you will have to work to find the cover, to find the coverage. You'll have to work to find the primer you like with this, because if you have texture and oily skin together like I do, you're going to be fighting kind of an uphill battle with it. I think it is workable for sure, and I think it's a beautiful foundation. I do have other ones that I like a lot more, you know, so I think that that's kind of a bummer. I did want to go through, because I realized I didn't do this in the first part of the video, so I thought I'd throw it in real quick. But this is, I'm just going to swatch these for you on my hand. I have a tiny swatch of lip liner from this morning, so don't mind that. But this is the stick foundation from today. I'm going to give you some swatches real quick. So let's do that, and then we're going to do a close-up. What else do I want to put with this? You guys, I'm in such a tired moment right now where I just can't. You ever just have one of those days where you're like, my God, am I tired? I feel like nothing is going, like everything I touch is kind of going to hell in a handbasket. That's how I feel today. And so I'm like, what an interesting day it's going to be to film. I'm having a minute. So on the first level up here, we have this Makeup Forever HD stick in the shade Y225. Right underneath of that, we have the Makeup Revolution stick foundation in F3. And then under that, we have the Physician's Formula, the Healthy Foundation. This is in LC1, which is this guy right here. Underneath of that, we have the one from Makeup Forever that I tested out earlier this week. This is their new formulated or whatever, the Matte Velvet Skin Foundation, and this is in Y215, so that is this one right here. And then last but not least, I figured I would go in with one more stick foundation, which is down here, and that is the Vanish Stick in the shade Alabaster from Hourglass, and again, that is right down here. So just a little bit of a shade comparison for you guys. And then while I'm in here, I figured I would go ahead and give you a nice little close-up. So this is where it sloughed off early this morning, but I think everything got kind of evened out and work together. Right in this area is where you can definitely tell my foundation kind of started to slide away. But for the most part, I feel like both sides evened out and really started to sink into their own. Now, what's interesting is this is the primerizer side, and I really feel like this side ended up at the end of the day not looking quite as nice as this side. I loved the way everything sat over here. Like bronzer, blush, highlight, I feel like my texture is a little lessened than it is over here. But this side didn't have nearly as much like moving around and sloughing off as this side did. So I don't know. Overall, I don't hate it. I think it's pretty good. I just think it might be a little bit too oily for me to use by itself, but not too shabby, right? But you can definitely see like this side is a little more emphasized, a little bit more irritated than this side. Like that's a pretty stark difference, right? I mean, but then here's this guy sloughing off, no sloughage over here. Wow, look at the oil on my nose. God, that is disgusting. So overall, you guys, I really feel like I said, this is a good foundation. I think it has a lot of pros. I don't know if you're oily skin, if this is what I would recommend to you. I would probably stick with like the Hourglass Vanish Stick or something like that. Something that has much more of an, even if it's not a matte finish, even a satin matte or something like that. Just you need something that has a lot more mattification properties to it. A, because when you're oily skinned, you're going to go in with more primers like the silicone primer. You're going to go in with stuff that is more pore filling or more drying on your skin. And I feel like that primer that you're more apt to go in with is going to fight the foundation. And it's important to remember that whenever you pick a foundation, you want to know that that's going to work well with whatever primer you use. So I always like to test out primers for you guys and differences and stuff, but the reality is that at the end of the day, is this something I would choose to wear in my day-to-day life? Probably not, just because it wasn't super pore refining or pore filling. And as far as it, how I would like change it, make it better, if it were me, I would have to start experimenting with like this primer I liked, you know, I think that that was pretty good, but I would want to go in with maybe less of this foundation, use it as a base, and then set it with my MAC Studio Fix foundation powder. I think that might work, or mixing it, maybe doing a couple swipes of this with a couple swipes of the Hourglass Vanishing Stick, something like that could work, but I think it's good. I just really feel like it might be geared for someone not quite as oily as me or not as much texture, but this foundation has been out for a long time, so I want to know your guys' thoughts down below. What do you think? Do you like it? All that good stuff, because I love hearing from you. So let me know all of your thoughts, and don't forget, leave me comments, love suggestions, whatever you want to leave me down there is great. You guys know I just couldn't go through and like not do another foundation review. When I was sitting there and I was reviewing that, where did it go? That Makeup Forever, that new one. I was reviewing that one in the previous video. And in it, I was like, oh, I have, you know, I have these foundations. I have to do it. And I'm not kidding you. I went like 4 days and I was like, I have to do this foundation review. I have to do it, because it was just, I had to. So anyways, it felt so good to do another foundation review. Let me know what you guys think down below. All of that good stuff. I know you guys love them. I love them. It's a good time. So while you're down there, don't forget, go check out the Instagram and the Twitter. That's usually the best place to keep up to date with me, the videos that are going, all that good stuff. And if you are new, please don't forget to subscribe. I put up new videos Monday through Friday. It is a good time. New products, old products, and everything in between. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Please do not forget to have a great day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. So I'm going to grab my Real Techniques. Hot potato, hot potato, woo! Hot tamale, wah! Stop. I'm going to get running off of camera. I will step back on, and I will step back in. So long, farewell, auf Wiedersehen, goodbye. What you know about me? What you know about me? Woo-hoo! All right, you guys, I am back. It has been just over 8 hours. What is this? What are we like boxing? What the hell, Paige? I'm sorry. Yes, Paramount Pictures. I'm sorry. I'm going to be booked all day that day. I know. I have lots of stuff booked in the studio. I got too much talent to go around. I don't know what to tell you. Sorry, boo-boo. It's a bummer. Sorry, boo-boo. Gotta go.